Frost diagrams are mechanisms for qualitative molecular orbital theory that help explain aromaticity and antiaromaticity in terms of a molecular orbital approach. Suppose we consider benzene as our first example. You draw the ring on its corner. As symmetrically as you can, and then draw a horizontal non-bonding line through the middle. Okay, so this is our non-bonding line, zero energy, for example. Okay, so this would be our zero line for energy axis, and we put our orbitals on the corners, where the corners are. And so anything below the zero energy line is a bonding molecular orbital, and anything above is an antibonding in the Frost diagram. And for benzene, where we have 6 pi electrons, we would fill in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and we get 3 pi bonding molecular orbitals. Remember, these are the p orbitals that we're representing in benzene. And suppose then we consider the cyclopentadienyl cation instead, and we draw it on its corner as symmetrically as we can. The midline is a little bit harder to determine for the 5-membered ring, but it's about right here. And we put orbitals at the corners, and then we fill with electrons. So what do we have? With the 5-membered ring, 4 pi electrons, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. And so although we don't necessarily indicate these top two in antibonding molecular orbitals, they are unpaired, and so we have a diradical. So the extreme instability of the cyclopentadienyl cation is actually more appropriately described by its diradical nature and high reactivity versus the all-paired and aromatic cyclopentadienide anion, which would then fill in two more electrons that would then pair all to become aromatic with 3 pi bonds. And so how do we predict what these molecular orbitals look like on the Frost diagrams? Well, it's all about the nodal planes. So if I draw benzene and all of its 6 p orbitals that are involved in these molecular orbitals, the lowest energy molecular orbital we're going to call psi 1, versus psi 2 and psi 3, psi 4, psi 5, and psi 6. The lowest energy, psi 1, is going to have everything in phase. All of the p orbitals have the green phase, I'll call it the plus phase, as the wave function. They're all going to be in phase on the top. If I look at this from a side view, it's going to look like a hamburger with a green top here. So they're all in phase. And there's a node at the nucleus for all p orbitals. That's why we have this straight line in the middle. Okay, so that's the side view of psi 1. And to predict the next higher energy molecular orbital, all you have to do is draw a nodal plane through the middle of the molecule. And so now I've separated left and right, or top and bottom, to where 3 are in phase and 3 are in phase on the other side, but out of phase with their partners across the nodal line. And so that's what psi 2 is. Psi 3 is the same energy as psi 2, and I could have equally drawn either one as one or the other, but let me straighten that up. There we go. For psi 3, the nodal line, same energy, so one nodal line goes down the middle, and two of the p orbitals are on the nodal line and go out of existence. But the others are still there, and they're in phase with each other, but they're not in phase with their partners across the nodal line. Okay. So then to get the next higher energy, and again we can show delocalization if we want to. So psi 1 complete, psi 2 side to side, and then between one side and the other. Four. And again, it's hard to draw the two on bottom as being in phase, two on top, and then their partners are not. Okay. They're in phase with each other, but not across the way. So the number of nodal lines determines the energy. So that means if we're going up in energy to the antibonding are going to have two nodal lines. So where are they at? Well, I can draw them here. And that would leave me with four orbitals not on nodal lines. But they are not in phase with anyone. Okay, so there's top, phase, bottom, and then across the way, not in phase, and not in phase across the nodal line. So all of these are four orbitals out of phase, two on the nodal line. Okay, so we could say that that's psi 4. Then with psi 5, we still have the same energy. So we still have two nodal lines, but instead of being two nodal lines up and down, perpendicular, that's going to, in an X fashion, that's going to put all the orbitals in existence. But on the left, these are in phase, then out of phase again, even though these share and are both phase top. These are out of phase, creating the nodal lines, the two nodal planes through the molecule, okay, which raises the energy up to the level of psi 4 just as equivalently. And then psi 6, just like the lowest energy, the highest energy is always easy to form because it's where everything's out of phase. And what that means is there's a nodal line here, here, and here. So there's three nodal lines. Up, down, up, down, up, down. And so completely out of phase, but again, it's predicted by the number of nodal lines through the compound.